Gentlemen, this match is the best of seven frames. This is the first frame with Robbie McGuigan to break.
Good morning, everyone. So, thanks for joining us for this semi-final match between Florian Neusler and Robbie McGuigan. So we're just having some slight technical difficulties at the start of this frame. We've had to change all the audio setups. Originally, we couldn't get commentary working on these back tables, but for the semi-finals, decided try and get them working for you.
Florian Neusler, one. Thank you, Robbie.
So, sorry again. Been some slight delays for the commentary here, but we should all be fine and up and running now.
Frau Animus, Florian Nusle, 4.
So that shot from Robbie, you're clearly in a lot of trouble. Definitely not gone to plan. So left Florian here with an easy starter. Well, he thought he'd put Robbie in enough trouble. So he's putting it back, a little bit surprised. So surely there'll be a lot of nerves in this match, but we'll see how both players can get settled into this first frame. Yeah, he's played that one well. And I'm sure Florian will now be regretting not attempting the red to the right centre before. This is much more difficult now.
One.
Yeah, nice start, Robbie. And now,
six.
Robbie will get the first good chance in this match.
Seven.
He's come through some really tight deciding frames in his previous three games as Robbie. But he'll be hoping things are a little bit easier for him in this match.
14.
We saw yesterday's quarter-final match. Robbie versus Julian Boyko on table one. Really was an incredible match to watch. But Robbie well and truly deserved that win. Held his nerve towards the end really well, being 3-1 up. Julian making an incredible break to force a decider. So just wanted to hit that one slightly. It's a little bit straight on the blue. Just have to roll the cue ball through slightly for the red to left hand black pocket.
28.
Yeah, that's nicely played. Screwing the cue ball back. The other side of the blue. It's got a nice angle now to come down the left hand side. The choice of reds, either to left centre or right corner.
Thirty 35.
So, overhit that one slightly. More angle on this black than he would have liked. So might have to try and play a cannon to the left hand, red of the three. Well, that's worked out well.
42.
So this has so far been a really nice start. Already looking so comfortable.
48.
We saw in his match against Julian
54.
How well he created chances for himself. He was always the first to get a good chance in the frame. In the vast majority of the frames anyway.
55.
Got him first. But he was breaking down two of the frames. He was punished after making 60 plus breaks and missing close to frame ball. So that one. It's in a little bit no man's land there with the cue ball. It's not ideal on any of these reds. Looks like he's going to try and cut this red back to the right centre.
Robbie McGuigan, 57.
Yeah, but trying to hold for the black isn't easy. So it was a lovely break. Still plenty on the table, Florian.
One.
Florian really has had some terrific wins to get here.
Six.
Against some really experienced players. He had a tough draw in 32 against Peter Lyons through that match 4-1. And then in the quarterfinals against Robin Hull.
Seven.
He won that one 4-2. So I've got to say that shows really good signs in his game, beating such experienced ex-professionals. So he's not ideal on this red. I'm sure he was playing to come off the cushion and play it down into the right hand corner, but if it does pass the pink to left corner, he can send the cue ball back up the table with safety in mind.
15.
Well, lovely pot. But not an ideal flick on the pink. Would have been going up nicely for the blue.
6.
20.
So only able to leave himself a really difficult red, but if he could manage to pop this one, the one closest to the pocket, he'd have a nice angle on the black to be able to get in behind or develop the other red.
21.
Well, lovely pot, but he just played that as more of a stun run through. He's come down now straight on the black.
13.
He might just have to bring the cue ball back and attempt a double on the red. So this next shot really is a big one. If this goes in with position on the black, he probably goes favourite for this frame.
40. Florian Neustay, 28.
No, but it's not there. He's left Robbie a chance of the red.
1.
Yeah, lovely pot. Perfectly on the blue. And the blue's all he'll need. So Florian, he ended up having a chance in a really awkward position. And did really well taking the red.
6.
Just couldn't manage to double the last one.
6.
So it's just one snooker needed. Probably missing the yellow. 8. Really is brilliant to see two young players, maybe these two, in this men's semi-final. Florian just 22 years of age and Robbie 19. So that's going to be
4.
Two snookers needed. That's if it's not a free ball. Another lovely shot. Keeping things tight here, Robbie. On the other table, we have Malta's Brian Cheney and England's Craig Stebman. But Craig, the only ex-professional left, but as well, he's one of the more experienced. Close.
2.
Well, he has snookered himself, but he'll still be happy to see the yellow disappear. So it's currently three snookers needed. Florian, I'm sure. He won't come back to the table if this green goes in. He'll clearly be using this time as well. Not only to attempt the snookers, but just get a feel for the table. It's still so early in the match. And with this game being so important, you can't blame him. So I'll try and keep you up to date with the scoring on the other table. I'll do that as best I can. It would have been nice if we could have potentially been able to flick over, show a little bit of coverage to the other table. If anything interesting happens, maybe that can be arranged in future tournaments. But Craig Stedman, he's taken the first frame. And purely based on experience, Craig, probably now the favourite of the tournament. But of course, the standard in these semi-finals are always so high. Be any one of the four that lift the trophy later today. So this looks close. Shouldn't be too much trouble though for Robbie.
Foul.
Robbie has missed it. Four. But played it at a pace where cue ball couldn't get behind the pink for a free ball. So still a big ask, but now only two snookers required. But that safety shot has gone wrong. Well, That's too thin. Overcooked to the center. Shot, but makes it easier with the green going so close to the cushion.
Three.
Well, clearly wasn't playing the double. But it was. It's made things easier for Florian with the blue and pink grouping around the green pocket. Getting a snooker behind them is going to be easier.
15. Florian Neusle, three.
That was really close. But you'll see Robbie having a go at this as soon as he pots one of these balls. He's had plenty of chances so far. If he can manage to pot one, I'm sure that'll be frame over.
Foul. Florian Neusle, six.
Well, that's a big mistake. But still, 23 points between them, 22 on the table. Now just one more snooker required for Florian.
Thank you.
So usually when your opponent needs a snooker in these sorts of positions, you'd be trying to drop the colour over the pockets. But it's a little bit different here, where the blue and pink are. If Florian gets the chance, it could potentially pop the brown and lay a snooker from the blue behind the pink. Was close to the cross double. But that's finished really well for Robbie. Looks as though it's a snooker and it's also a pretty difficult one to hit. Oh, well played, finding the gap between pink and blue. Another half chance. Just look close to maybe going in off. Maybe it'll just be a safety shot. One. Yeah, that's nice. Pushing the blue close to the vault cushion. It's one less colour that Florian can get a snooker behind. Really trusting the table not to drift there, Florian. So it's a nice shot. A lot of pressure on this now, Robbie. Well played. Nearly potted it to the centre. So another chance for Robbie, he'll be taking this on. Well played.
Four.
So back to two snookers required.
Robbie McGuigan, four.
Well, very nearly. Great snooker. Robbie can potentially get to the potting angle.
One.
Frame conceded. Robbie McGuigan wins the frame.
Well, after all that, it's a little bit surprising, Florian. That safety shot just deciding to stay in his chair. What a great first frame. 50-plus break from Robbie. Things got really tense towards the end. Florian needed three snookers. Got two of them. But it's Robin McGuigan that takes the first frame.
The second frame, Florian Neuslater break. Yeah, Robbie.
14.
Not played that too well. Trying to get the cue ball back to the black cushion. And he's left a chance now for Florian. could be quite a big mistake if this red's available to the left centre. Another shot where Robbie was trying to get the cue ball close to the black cushion.
One.
Plenty of reds available in the balk end.
Eight.
So we'll see how costly that mistake's going to be from Robbie. Clearly wasn't a difficult shot at all, just coming thin off the reds, trying to get the cue ball close to the black cushion.
Nine.
The wrong side of the blue. Florian. Doesn't look like he's got much of a good angle to do anything, really. Potentially a red to the green pocket. But that looks awkward. I don't know if one of two reds on the left-hand side might be possible if Florian can drop the blue in.
Fifteen.
Yeah, struck that so well. Really nice bit of cue in from Florian. Flying loose then, 20. So it didn't look too difficult, that red. It's a surprising miss on the other table. Craig Stedman's taken second frame to lead 2-0 against Brian Cheney. Really nice angle on the blue. Split the reds. Didn't catch the pick as intended, but it's worked out okay. It's another angle now, though.
Seven.
Colour. And nicely on the black. Yeah, that's worked out well again. It'd be nice as long as he can get to the centre of the cue ball. Clearly can.
15. 22. 23.
Well, it doesn't look ideal. This for Robbie. It's going to be awkward if he was going to try and get into the four reds. Yeah, just decided to play.
29.
A loose red. It's almost the left cushion, but he's a little bit short. Makes this pot more awkward.
30.
Yeah, it's nicely played, but slightly out of position again. So it's difficult to see whether he can get through straight to the red closest to the corner, or he's going to have to play the plant one onto the other. Doesn't look like he's too sure himself. Nicely played. He's going to need another good pot. In potting this black, he's always going to have a chance with the red close to the green pocket, but then that also won't be easy. It's a lovely pot. Decided to play with a lot more pace. Try and get close to the red. Well, he's never quite been prime position during this break. A lot of good pots keeping it going. Oh, that's really unlucky.
46.
Played it a lot harder than I expected him to.
Robbie McGuigan.
So close to 46. Opening the reds. Yeah, the only thing about the shot previously from Robbie, just dropping up into the reds, it always gives Florian a chance to put him in a bit of trouble. Cue ball behind the pink and black. Luckily for him, he's not managed to do it. Well, it looks thin. I'm sure that red to the left centre is available. Doesn't like it. But with 26 points behind, it's not a bad thing to be developing this red.
One.
That's a lovely pot, but this cue ball's going really tight to the ball cushion. Makes both the pot, the yellow, and dropping up behind it really difficult.
Florian Neusle, one.
Yeah, he's played that well.
Foul and a miss. Florian Neusle, four.
15. 16. Fine. Okay. Yeah, thank you, gentlemen. So, two cushions. Trying to catch the red. It's closest to the left centre.
Foul and a miss. Florian Neusle, four. Foul and a miss. Florian Neusle, four.
So not got too close yet. These points starting to add up.
Foul. Florian Neusle, four.
Well caught. The wrong side of the red, which I'm sure he was intending to hit. Was still difficult. These middle pockets playing really tight.
46.
One.
Yeah, and similar to how Florian got the long red previously. Ruffy's got a really good cue ball. For the safety aspect of that shot, but Not very good for him now. Been attempting a pot of playing safe. Won't even be attempting to drop up behind a colour.
Robbie McGuigan, one.
Didn't like any of the safety shots, thought potentially could have come thin off the red closest to the left centre, but the jaws in the pocket and the yellow were making that difficult.
One. Six. Seven.
Got an ideal angle on the blue. I'm sure he would want to try and drop this red into the left centre, but to get nicely on that, going to get close in behind it. So there might be an attempt at the pot. Be screwing the cue ball back towards the brown in case he does miss. Oh, that's 13. A brilliant pot. It really is. But to play it at that pace is so aggressive. Shows how well he must be feeling.
18.
Just making sure of the blue. Florian now needs one snooker.
18. Foul. Lauren Newsley, four.
So he's got the snooker. Surely, too big of a shot to take on now, this yeller. Yeah, just a safe shot, trying to get the cue ball behind pink and black. But it looks like he's left it for Robbie. So, where's it going to finish? That's any good. So Florian's going to get a chance. Clearly still really awkward with where the pink and black are.
Two.
But potentially even if Florian didn't want to risk the cannon to the pink and black, he can bring the cue ball down close to the black cushion. Play a really good snooker.
Five.
From the pink in behind the black.
Nine.
So this, clearly a really big shot.
14.
So miss the cannon. Does he have a chance to get a nice snoop behind the black? Does look a little bit awkward. I don't think it's going to be a good one. It might just be able to drop the cue ball slightly behind the black.
Sorry, on this thing. 14. Foul. And a miss. Sorry, foul. Or on your stage, six. And a miss. And a free ball. Got that, yeah.
So, a bit of confusion from the referee, and he's not putting this back
yeah.
in the right spot.
You came this way, didn't you? Yeah. And you weren't touching the black. Yeah, like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, Florian? Thank you, gentlemen. Foul. And miss. Florian Newsday. Six.
Well, really surprised that Robbie's missed this.
Free ball.
Now twice.
Back.
Changes things, so it's now Florian that just needs the pink, where Robbie needs both pink and black. So big shot, dropping this into the left centre. Not there, but has he fluked it? Wow.
Six. And the front.
What a massive fluke. Really is incredible. So after Robbie McGuigan put an incredible frame ball red down the cushion with the rest, dropping the blue in, missed the yellow. Florian then quickly got a snooker, cleared down to pink. And with Robbie missing that snooker twice on the pink and black, and that Florian just needed the pink. give him the chance to just try and drop it into the centre with no position on the black. Made things a lot easier for him, but he missed the pot and fluked it to the opposite centre. So that really could be big in this match. We'll see how much that'll affect Robbie.
The third frame, Robbie McGuigan to break.
So clearly a bit disappointed the way Robbie lost that previous frame, but we've seen a lot of the young lads' good mental games so far this week. Clearly coming through three deciding frames in a row to get here. Shows how mentally tough he is, especially the one against Julian Boyko.
One.
He's been given a really early chance now. Try and forget about that previous frame now. Sure, a big break here would help him do just that.
Nine.
So playing on the red, underneath the pack,
16.
To the right corner. He's played it well. He had to be careful not to hamper himself, the other red. So he's going to be opening everything up now.
17.
Well, didn't get into the cue ball enough. This black's now going to be very tricky.
Robin McGuigan, 17.
Yeah, especially when he's playing it, screwing around for two cushions.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, Florian jumping up off that shot as soon as he's hit it new. Push the red thick.
There you go, Robin.
But the cannon to the black might have just took his eye off the pot. He was always going to go into the black, tried to judge that cannon.
One. Eight. Nine.
So the reds may be a fraction awkward, but you can stun the cue ball up the left hand side. You're on a choice of reds.
Excuse me, Robbie. Seventeen.
So a little bit thin on this black mat, just play the cannon. Well, I thought he was going to try and play that small gap between the reds, but I didn't 24. Think he was going to play it that hard.
Rob McGuigan, 24.
So, no problem with a safety shot, but it will be slightly disappointed, I'm sure, to not make more from that chance. Attempting the pot, trying to bring the cue ball back up the table, but caught it too thick. That's why the cue ball didn't have enough pace to get up around bolt colours.
One.
Seven.
8. Sorry, in this then, 8.
Yeah, that was an easy enough pot, but he didn't have a natural angle to top the cue ball up and down. 15. The cue ball was always going a little bit close to the jaws, and then it had been coming down onto the side cushion.
One.
What a big let off for Robbie.
Five.
Yeah, nicely played. So everything's there for him now to get over that disappointing second frame and get back in front. Eleven. 17. 18. So the black put Robbie 58 in front with 59 on the table. So it'll just be one more red needed.
25.
So it's been a nicely played frame. He has given Florian a couple of chances. 42. But he wasn't punished.
32.
That pink will mean that there'll be four snookers required. I'm sure Florian won't be going back to the table.
32, and the frame.
So, a great way to come back from the disappointing frame, win the next, and he has a one frame lead again. Rob McGuigan leads Rory and Noosa 2-1. Previously, we heard some clicking coming from the other table. 56. Brian Cheney took the third frame. But Craig Stedman straight back in. Break 56. So he's looking like going 3-1 up.
Thank you. see it.
Fourth frame, Florian Neusley to break. 1.
Yeah, lovely pop. Dragging the cue ball, playing it really low to hold it for the black without using the black cushion. So it looks a little bit awkward, his next red. To develop them. He played the cannon really well. Caught the right side of the red, brought the cue ball back towards the centre of the table. A little bit unlucky not to be on an easier red than this.
Nine.
So, will Florian be taking the brown to either the right centre or right black pocket? Nicely played.
13.
That wasn't an easy shot. I had a lot of angle on that brown. More good shot now to get back in prime position.
Fourteen.
Yeah, lovely shot. So overhit that slightly. We're having to use the spider. He's straight enough. Should be okay. A little bit straight on the black again. Might have to screw back off the cushion with a bit of reverse side for the two reds to the right of the pink.
29.
Yeah, lovely shot. And now definitely at least one red available to the left corner, one he's closest to now. Well, has he gone far enough?
45.
Well, it looks like there's a red in the middle of the four. They're all closest to the pink. And it looks as though that'll open everything up.
46.
So now it looks like you can stun the cue ball up. Maybe play a cannon to the one on the right hand side, that's middle of the table.
Fifty-four.
Yeah, it's been a lovely break so far. He's going to need two more reds. Yeah, so this red is going to be frame ball.
69.
Oh, well played. This really has been a nice break. Really well controlled from, apart from the first few shots, all come about from a really tricky brown to the centre. The split
76.
Originally didn't work out too well. He himself with a difficult cut to the left-hand centre. He got a cannon to the pink. The yellow.
77.
Put a lovely brown to the right centre to keep the break going.
73.
And from then on, he's never looked like missing. Always been in perfect position.
83.
Controlled the cue ball so well. So can he now make a century break? He's going to need one of the more tricky reds.
91. Florian Neuster.
So 91. It's not going to be a century, but a lovely break of 91. Florian.
Florian Neuster wins the
crucial frame. This match where it could have been either 2-2 or 3-1 down. But that break of 91 means after four frames, these two players have shared both. So the scoreline is 2-2.
The fifth frame, Robbie McGuigan to break. One.
So lovely pop as he played it hard enough to get the other side of the ball colours. And that's brilliant. Straight back in, and it already looks like a good chance. You've opened reds.
Five.
Got to say, I'm a little bit surprised that for the format of the tournament, we're still playing best of seven matches, given that we was playing best of seven all the way from the last 92. Thought by semi-finals they would have upped it. I know the final will be a best of nine. So couldn't avoid the cannon to the red. Let's try and judge the cannon to leave himself on the red, but not ideal. Looks a little bit too straight. It's going to be a difficult pot, especially if he tries to power it, the cue ball in, back off the side cushion.
Brian Newsley, 20.
Yeah, that's exactly what he's tried. So Robbie's blocked off the path to the red on the left-hand side of the table. It's going to make this safety shot a lot harder for Florian. Played it nicely. So Florian opted not to take one of the two long reds on down the right-hand side. But that safety shot's not worked out for him. It's a little bit awkward for Robbie in getting the cue ball out for a colour.
One.
Yeah, that's worked out okay.
Pink ball.
It looks as though the pink will go on the black spot, but that means it'll also be tied up.
Seven. Eight.
So this break's going to be quite tricky. Just be using the blue and bolt colours for now.
Thirteen.
So it doesn't look like he's got a great angle on this red to get up for the blue. It'll be stunning off the side cushion and back across the other 20. Side of the blue, but to play with a lot of pace. Finish the wrong side. Things so much more difficult. These sorts of breaks, finishing wrong side of the blue. Going to be left with a really tricky next shot. Well, he's done really well.
25.
Too straight to force that much of an angle out that blue. It's going to need a good pot here, but he's got a natural angle to go back up for the blue.
26.
Franchini, 3.
So not got an angle on the other red. He's going to have to play the thin cut with awkward bridging.
32.
Well, he's done a really good job so far. Taking these reds with blues.
38.
But now he's running out of loose reds to play on. It's like the two closest together in the middle of the table. I don't think they will pop. I have to try and play a cannon for them.
Yeah,
another lovely pot, but it's always going to be difficult to get high on the blue. Sure, he could have screwed the red in, played a difficult black down the cushion. That would have been easier positionally for a shot, but
49.
Now I've got a difficult red to keep this break going.
50.
Well, lovely pot, but he's not nicely on a colour. This will probably just be a safety shot.
Green ball.
So 30 points in front, he'll be looking to put this green safe.
Bobby McGuigan, 50.
Yeah, he's played it nicely. He has left this red on the left hand side for Florian. It's a really difficult pot. The other two reds not available. It's going to need an angle and a colour to play the cannon.
1. Oh, sorry, Robbie.
Well, it was close. So, will he now look? Drop another colour safe. Surely, either the brown or the yellow.
Brown ball. Robbie McGuigan, 1.
Yeah, that's good enough. Wanted to guarantee the snooker as well.
7.
really fortunate. Caught the wrong side of the red. Shoy was trying to play thin off the left-hand side as we're looking. Yeah, so it wasn't too difficult of a safety shot. Florian very nearly left a red on and would have been frame over with the red and just one more colour for Robbie. Seen in these tactical battles at the ends of the frames, Florian so far has been really strong. In the first frame, he needed three snookers at one stage. He didn't get them all, but played a nice frame in getting two of them. And then in the second frame, obviously he won that with a fluke, but did need a snooker in that frame also. So that previous shot from Florian did its job by developing the brown, putting it over the pocket. So Robbie could potentially attempt the red to the yellow pocket, but needs to be careful, doesn't want to develop the green. So in the other semi-final, Craig Stedman has just got himself in front in the frame that he needs to get to the final. He's 3-1 up. Now he's on a nice break. But he's got a couple of reds close to a cushion, so still a bit of work to be done for him. Brilliant cue ball. It's going to make the safe shot really difficult now for Florian. 31. Yeah, definitely not how he played it. He was trying to get the red past the right hand side of the brown to the bolt cushion.
One.
So it's a thin cut for this brown, this frame ball. Nicely played and getting a good cannon to the red, so I'm sure this red will make sure of the frame. So similarly to Craig Stedman, Rob McGuigan is going to be one frame away from placing the final.
Robbie McGuigan, 13, and the front.
Yeah, it's so impressive. Still looks so cool under the pressure in this match. Well, both players do, but it's Robbie McGuigan that wins this frame. Take a 3-2 lead.
Sixth frame. Florian knows the to break. One.
So it's now Robbie that flukes one into that right centre.
Robbie McGuigan, one.
He's played that well in dropping up. Shouldn't be too much trouble for Florian dropping into the reds, but still need to be careful. There's a few reds that could possibly leave if he doesn't get it exactly right. So it looks like Craig Stedman has got a really important green in his match. Potentially winning the game 4-1. That's a brilliant safe shot. Florian had to catch that red so thin to avoid the jaws of the pocket. Just crept past the green. It still looks like quite a lot of trouble for Florian. So there was a small gap in the reds. Florian to get the cue ball back to Volk. Well, and that's the problem, not getting the cue ball tight enough to the bulk cushion. Or he could get his hand on the table. A wonderful pot.
Eight. Nine.
Well, the black is going to be out of commission. So he'd like to get the pink on its own spot.
Fat. Robert McGuigan, nine. Florian Nusselet, six.
Well, by the looks of it, maybe pot of the pink in the wrong part of the pocket. Maybe trying to pinch a bit of the pocket and screw the cue ball back below the middle pocket to make the pot on the next red a little bit easier, but he definitely didn't have to play that. Could have just held the cue ball, just pulled it back slightly from where the pink was, left himself one from range. Looks like a great saved shot. And Florian is going to make things difficult. Even the dump shot. Possibly got a chance of leaving this red nicely for Florian. Clearly wanted to get a really tight cue ball to the black cushion. So a big shot now for Florian in taking the red to left corner. He can cannon the red above it. Finish on the black. But he has got other options. Maybe red to the left centre as well. Was a big shot. So another chance for Robbie. It's been a little bit fortunate for Florian to not develop the black. But Robbie should be fine taking pinks. It's available to most pockets. Well, clearly it's going to start getting really nervy towards the end of this match.
One.
Well, it looks like Craig Sedman's done it on the other table.
Eight.
He has missed a pink over the yellow pocket, but Ryan Cheney now needs a snooker with just pink and black on the table.
Yeah,
so you can just hear there, Craig Stedman's potted the last pink to win the match 4-1. It's not as Brian Cheney. Still an amazing run for Brian. Get to the semi-final.
Quite
a great
can,
win last
please.
Night against England's Paul Deville in the quarter-final. So it looks like after this red, there's one more available to the right corner.
Quietly, please. 29.
Not finished ideally on the pink, so it's going to be an awkward positional shot. Now coming round off two cushions. two reds to the right corner. The top one definitely be potable. Maybe them both.
Thirty-five. 36.
So potting that red definitely opens up the other, and you can use that red as long as you get the right angle on it. So that's trying to open up a few of the other reds.
Forty-three.
Yeah, played that really well. Forcing the cue ball up to a big area for blue or bolt colour, so we found to be on a colour and then open the reds really nice.
Forty-nine.
So that pink puts flying 51 points ahead, behind on the table. He just needs
55.
This red, and Robbie will need a snooker. Snooker needed the black and another red. We'll make sure of the frame. Are we going to a decider?
Sixty-four.
60. Decider if Robbie could do it would be quite amazing to say that in getting to the final every match from the last 32
71
he's won a deciding frame.
Seventy-two. 79. 80. 83.
So up to and including the pink for a century break.
85. 88. 92.
So Florian initially missed a red down black cushion to develop the black. There's been no mistake here.
97.
After Robbie missed a red to the right centre.
103.
Brilliant. What a great way to put Robbie under it for the deciding frame.
Florian Nieuwsteen, 110
lovely break
in the frame.
For the 110. Florian. Both players will be having a minute. They'll come back for the decider. The winner will meet Craig Stedman. 2 o'clock final.
seventh final and deciding frame. With Robbie McGuigan to break.
So great to hear the crowd there supporting both players. So surely it'll be a nervy one, but who can hold their nerve better? Oh, Florian's missed by some way. He's not got away with it. It's been a little bit lucky, pushing the black safe.
One.
Pink a little bit awkward also.
Six. Seven.
Lovely shot. Plenty of angle on this blue. Doesn't need to go into them. Be dropping down for the two reds to the left corner.
Twelve. Thirteen. Blue ball.
So not enough. Reverse side on the cue ball. So a big shot. Long blue to the yellow pocket. Wow, brilliant.
18. Robbie McGuigan, 18.
Well, he still does look really confident around the table, but he'll clearly be feeling it. So things are even more awkward now. Blue green safe. So it looks as though he's got a cover on the red closest to the left corner. Florian, I'll need to get cover onto that red now as well. That's a lovely shot. The cue ball so tight to the ball cushion, blocking off the right hand side of the table with the yellow. Florian's going to have to be really accurate with a saved shot. Well played. Has been caught a little bit thick. Has he got the cover to the red closest to the corner? If not, Florian might be able to plant one red onto the other and get a path back to the bulk end for the cue ball.
One.
Yeah, so no real attempt to get the cue ball out for a colour. Just getting rid of that red and now playing a good safety shot.
Foreign new slave one.
So with the black now in the open and the reds really nicely spread, surely the next person to get in the balls is going to have a good chance to win this match. Florian now looking at the long red.
One.
Lovely pot. Needs the cue ball to slow down slightly. So it looks as though it's a little bit awkward on the air, a little bit close. But I'm sure he can just pull the cue ball back slightly and play the red closest to the left corner.
Florian Newsley, one. One.
Wow, what a lovely shot. Brought the cue ball up nicely for either black or pink. So here's your chance.
Nine.
And what a good chance it is. Looks as though all these reds are available to the left corner.
Sixteen. Seventeen. Four. 25.
So I've gone a little bit close to the black, but he's okay. He can just stun past the other red, which is in the left corner. Well, screws it back.
32.
Still perfectly played.
33.
Well, still playing. So quick and fluently. Really is lovely to watch.
40.
So this black now, lovely pot to the middle, is for the match. 48. So well deserved round of applause.
Forty-nine.
And that'll make sure of this match. I've not seen all of Robbie's deciding frames this week, but the ones I have seen, he's been really impressive in them. Super cool under pressure. And now he'll be amazing to watch in the final against Craig Stedman.
56.
It really is incredible. In the last 32, beat Daniel Womersley 3-2. Then Shakar Ruberg 3-2. Julian Boyko. 4-3. Julian Boyko 4-3. And now Florian Neusel 4-3.
64.
So what a relief. It'll be for him.
71.
I could be mistaken, but I do think it's Robbie's first match to get on the tour for this final. See what it means to him.
Robbie McGuigan, 71, and the frame and the match. Well played from you.
So kind words will be said between the two players. It really was a great match to watch. And now he's got just over an hour to relax, prepare for the final. That'll be at 2 o'clock local time in Bosnia. Currently he's 25-1. So hard luck. Florian Neusel, he played really well in this match. A century break to force a decider. But he comes up short in the decider after missing the yellow to the green pocket. So thanks a lot, everyone, for joining us for the semi-final. It won't be too long until we're back for the final. That'll be on table one, slightly different table. Table is a Rasson, not Star. So we'll see how both players can adjust to the table. The match will be Robbie McGuigan versus England's Craig Stedman. So thanks a lot, everyone. I'll be joining you then as well. See you for that one.